Second Punic War, 207 BC. Hasdrubal Barca, famed Hannibal Barca's brother, is in trouble. Attempting to retreat in the night from the combined might of Claudius Nero and Marcus Livius's armies proved misfortunate, as Hasdrubal's guides betrayed him, leaving him lost, futilely searching for a ford to cross. The morning finds him facing the Roman Republic's army with most of his Gallic troops drunk, his army in complete disarray, and trapped against the banks of the Metaurus. Hello everybody, this is Havoc. Welcome to the Ancient Empires mod, a Total War Attila overhaul mod. We are playing the Battle of the Metaurus between the Roman Republic and the Carthaginian Empire. I hope you enjoyed that intro, and hope just kind of prepared you for the epicness that is about to ensue. So again, I am playing as the Roman Empire. Fighting me today is Petilius, one of the devs of the game. He's kind enough to play a battle with me and explain some of the things going on with the mod in general. Look at the epicness of this fight. I mean, that's a lot of troops, and this is just a 1v1. Anyways, so let's go ahead and go through the armies real quick before the battle actually starts. I think he's still positioning some troops. Over here on my right flank, I have 3-4 units. Triarii. These guys are amazing. I love the way they look. We're actually going to slow it down to half speed. I love the way these guys look. The shields in the ground with their spears dug into the dirt behind them. They look extremely professional. They are very heavy spear infantry, and they will screw you up. Believe it. And their shields are also quite amazing as well. Got a little bit of that chainmail armor going on. Just look at them. They are absolutely gorgeous. Here in the middle of the flank, we have 5 units of Principes. This is going to be our main column and our main support. And as you can see, they are a very rambunctious bunch, throwing their swords in the air in celebration to fight these Carthaginians in the Battle of Metaurus. Yes, and over here on our left flank, we have 3 units of Hastati. They are heavy melee infantry. And behind each of these columns is a unit of Veletes. Now, we tried to keep this as historically accurate as possible. That being said, there are some things we just couldn't do. We are fighting on a river. The flanks are on the right side. Over here, there's supposed to be some impassable terrain, but we kind of just agreed not to go all the way up to the hill. The cav are on the right side, so we have a pretty historically accurate battle going on here, and even parts of the battle that we did just fighting each other is a little more historical as well, unintentionally so, but it worked out, pretty darn good. So let's take a look at the Carthaginians. Over here, he's going to actually move these before the actual battle starts. These are some Iberian Catrati. I'm going to butcher these names, by the way, so pardon me. I hope I don't completely butcher them. They are hidden troops, and they will stay hidden for quite a while. A lot of the troops in the Carthaginian army are able to do so, and so you can set up some pretty sweet ambushes with them, and they are already shooting at me. He accidentally forgot to turn them off, and some dude, I think, actually dies before he realizes it. Anyway, so the Carthaginians have a very big... I'm going to pause it just in case the battle starts. No, because they'll be over there, that's right. They have a very mixed nationality army, and this was true even historically as well. So their rosters are pretty historical. They have Gauls, they have Iberians, they have Italians, they have Celts, they have obviously Carthaginians. So over here, they have some mercenary Celtic warband. We are going to pretend that these guys are ragingly drunk. Mercenary Celtic warbands, the Gauls, they were drunk in this battle. That led to part of the demise of Hasdrubal's army. It was pretty funny to read about that. But anyways, we got some African veterans. These guys are not to be messed with. You don't screw around with these guys, and you'll see why here in a little bit. The shields do look absolutely gorgeous. I love shields, and I love the work that all of these big overhaul mods have been put in. To just shield and armor design is great. Mercenary Samnite Spearmen, they have some more African veterans. African veterans, Mercenary Samnite Spearmen. Those shields are just great. And then Italian infantry, so we got some traitors to the Empire, or to the Republic here. They will die nonetheless. And then some mercenary Sabilian spearmen as well. These round shields look very nice. I love the round shield look. And I love the designs that are built into these round shields. Now, flanking them in the back, we have a couple units of Sardinian archers. These bow infantry acts can cause quite a bit of damage and some havoc later on in the battle. We'll have to try and keep an eye out on it, but no guarantees. We have some Balearic slingers here. We have some Iberian, the same, Scutari. Scutari, I think that's how you say them. They have two units of Iberian Catrati Cav, and these guys are going to do the best they can. Oh, I like the medallions. Look at that, man. Look at that detail. But hey, what's up? Anyways, and then I forgot to mention over here, I have four units of Equites Extraordinarii now in the battle. Roman Cav did outnumber the Carthaginian Cav. And so again, I mean, we're sitting at, what, I'm almost 4,600, he's a little over 4,400. The Carthaginians in this battle had 30,000 soldiers estimated, and the Romans had 47,000 estimated soldiers. So this is kind of close-ish. He actually probably should have a little less, but whatever. We decided to give it a go. And then also, I forgot to mention my general, who is labeled as Publius Cornelius Scipio Africanus, but today he is relabeled Gaius Claudius Nero indeed. All right, so let's go ahead and hit play, and I think we're just getting set up. We may start here in just a second. Here it goes. Right off the bat, archers are going to take down some of these principes. The Romans are going to move forward. In anticipation, they don't want to get too hammered before they get into contact. Oh, absolutely. Oh, it's just awful. The Hastati, they're going to move in a formation, but they're going to see the scouts. They're going to see these light infantry, and as a result, going to make a slight wedge formation over here to help combat that. The formations here are pretty cool. I'll have to say so myself. I like how I did this battle. In terms of the formations, it seemed to work very effectively. So there's that slight wedge to help counter those guys. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to split my Triarii into two separate groups and do the same wedge. That's just covering my flank. And just look at the organization. Look at the organization of these guys. Let's slow this down because I really want to see this up close and just in the slow-mo. They're just super organized. Just look how amazing that looks. Oh, what are you guys doing? What are you guys doing? Oh, those are my Velites. They're going to come in and start shoosting stuff. As you can see, after only a few volleys, this unit of Hastati is almost ready to rout. I mean, they are definitely going to get... they're going to get some heat for sure. All right, and over here, you're going to ready for this charge? I think you are. Oh, there we go. Guys got knocked back. Absolutely gorgeous. And we missed the charge here, but that's all right. Here we go. We missed another charge. Is there going to be a charge here? There is. I can feel it. I can feel it. I just like seeing the charges in this game. Oh, sick. Hitting those Balearic slingers for sure. Here we go. Here we go, guys. Slow motion. Runaway horse. Oh, here we go. Oh, there we go. Oh yeah, let's get back into real time. Let's get those... look at those animations. I love the animations in this game. They are quite amazing. And we're... the Romans, they're going to push a unit of Equites through. They're actually going to squeeze and try and hit the mercenary Celtic warband in the back. Just a little bit. It's not a super successful charge. They don't have quite enough the momentum that they need. We're going to try and squeeze these Equites through. And we're going to do a charge onto these Celtic warband. There we go. That was a much stronger charge. That is going to have much more devastating effect on their morale. Whoa, dude. You're showing off a little too much skin there. There we go. That was a good one. Let's see how the left flank is doing. This unit of Velites, they are going to come in. They're going to get stuck fighting these mercenary Sabellian spearmen. Over here, those scouts have engaged both of my units of Astati, with the mercenary Celtic warbands engaging the last force. Over here on the left flank, not a whole terrible lot happens. Here we go, though. Look at this. Look at this. They see a gap there. General's under attack. That's no big deal. There's going to be a gap here, these Velites. They're going to come through and attack the Sardinian archers. That is ingenious. Look, they're just going to march right through. Hey, what's up, guys? Don't worry about us. Don't worry about us. Meanwhile, some Equites have gotten a hold of the Balearic Slingers. That's not going to go well. Oh, wow, look at those Balearic Slingers taking down horsemen. Oh, man, you didn't expect that to happen. Gaius Claudius Nero is circling around. What's he going to do? Just check out this whole battle line, though. I mean, look at this. There's just pockets everywhere. You could do some pretty epic cinematic shots with this mod for sure. And just look at that. You can see the units in the back and the distant battlefield. It is amazing. It is just so gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Alright, so their sacred band, they're going to go after my Equites, but I don't think they're going to reach them. Equites are just a little too quick. Our Hastati have been routed. So what are we going to do? We're going to bring our Velites, these light skirmishers. Are they going to be able to hold up against the Iberians? We'll have to see. We're going to charge into battle. Light skirmishers against light infantry. Oh, go for the charge. Go for the charge. Charge into them, lads. Oh, yeah, there we go. Oh, that charge bonus. There we go. Very nice. Good charge, boys. Oh, we almost missed this. Our Cav have this field over here. We have, what, three units engaged fighting off these two units. That leaves some hammer and anvil tactics to run rampant in the Carthaginians' backside, and you are about to get to see one of those charges right about now. Oh, here we go. Oh, man. That was a glorious charge. You didn't really get to see it from all the way back there, which is a little unfortunate. Oh, but here comes another charge. Oh, my word. From Nero himself, and he is going to rout. He is going to rout that unit of mercenary Samnite spearmen. This Celtic warband has been routed as well. It is not looking good for the Carthaginians at all. The Romans just have free reign to carve up these guys, hitting them in the back. Carthaginians see that spearmen, see the horsemen coming in. The horsemen are like, no thanks. We will back off. Unless this brave soul decides to change his mind. There we go. We have some Triarii. They are engaging the sacred band. The general of the Carthaginians. We will see here how well he does that. The Velites are actually, they fought off an entire unit of these Iberians. Then they are taking on those other dudes as well. Yeah, it's not looking good for the Carthaginians at all. Oh, here we go. A devastating charge. Nothing but charges in this battle, baby. There we go. Oh, my word. These charges are just amazing. It's hard to break off of a melee engagement to help fight off these Cav. If you turn around, you get stuck with my Triarii. Otherwise, you get hit in the back with my Equites. It's just not a good place to be in. So we've routed the middle of the flank, of the right of the left flank. I guess the right side of the left flank, if that makes sense. Oh, yeah. And we've routed those African veterans. That's going to help us. And just in the nick of time, we're actually routed two of these units. What is that? These are Iberian Scutari. and the Iberian Caitrati Cav. Now we have the another units of Iberian Scutari, but I imagine they will get wrecked pretty soon. We're going to send a unit of Principes to help fight off these Sardinian archers, who are actually holding out pretty stinking well, I'm surprised. And we've had a unit of Triarii route. The Sacred Band, they are epic. Oh, you got dead. But that's no match, because these Triarii are coming in to save the day. Oh yeah, and then you're gonna get hammer enameled in the back. I can feel it. Getting that charge set up. Look at the blood. These guys have done some serious work today. As soon as those Cav get ready, they are going to attack. Here they come. Charge. Oh, screenshot heaven right there. Oh yeah. That is glorious. And those units are probably, that's the Sacred Band. They will rout soon. I can feel it. And we missed a charge by our General Nero over here, but that is okay. As you can see, those Sardinian archers, they're holding out pretty well. I'm surprised at how well they're holding out against these Principes, to be completely honest. Here comes another charge. These guys are getting hammer and anvil to death. Quite literally. Oh man, they should rout soon, I bet. Yep, there they go. Oh, it is a bloody fight to the end, but we are definitely winning this engagement. They are starting to mass rout. There goes the chain rout. The general's had enough. Hasdrubal has had enough. I don't even think we're going to get the charge in there beforehand. Yep, they are mass routing. Can we get that? Nope, we don't get the charge in. Alright guys, well that is a decisive victory. Let's end the replay and take a look at our units. So as you can see, I have almost 4,600 troops. I lost 1,388 for a total of 3,202 left. Petilius, he fought well, he fought valiantly, but he still lost. Lost over half of his men. Over here, look at that. Gaius Claudius Nero, you got 421 kills. Looks like 90, 65, 137, 100 with our Triarii. Our Principes, 182. Even here, look, our Valete's got 105. This dude got none, and he got wrecked. Over here, though, our Equites Extraordinarii, they got quite a few kills as well. Over here, let's see what they got. General didn't get too bad of kills. These mercenary civilian spearmen got 183. I can't see how many that is. 110. That's probably about 110. 97. So they fought valiantly, but they lost nonetheless. Now, historically, the Battle of Metaurus, it was pretty much one of the most pivotal battles in the Second Punic War. Not long before this, Hannibal Barca, further south, was defeated by the Romans. So between this defeat in the south by his brother Hannibal and Hasdrubal's defeat at the Metaurus, that really just completely put a halt to their campaign in northern Italy and really gave the Romans some breathing room to be able to push back and fight off the Barcas. It helped end the Second Punic War. To an extent, I mean, obviously, it was one of the most decisive battles of the war and really brought Rome into the superpower light, considering that Carthage was soon to be knocked out of its supremacy. So I hope you guys enjoyed the Battle of the Metaurus. Thank you, Petilius, for having a battle with me. The link to his page will be in the description. He has shown off a couple of few things about the Ancient Empires mod. He is, like I said, one of the head devs. So, Here in the near future, when the dev team gets ready, they are going to give me some special access to some things that they really want me to show off, and I am super excited about it. So guys, make sure you stay tuned to this channel for sure. If you have any historical battles you want me to fight in this era, just about every faction you can think of is in the game for this time period, this ancient empire's time period. So send me a historical battle my way, and I'll see what I can't do to get it fought for you and posted onto my channel. If you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Follow me on Twitch, Twitter, and Facebook. This is Havoc, and I am out of here. Peace!